we've seen how significant classes are for controls in implementing a design system. So far, we've worked almost exclusively with the controls provided by the GeneXus toolbox. We have simple controls, as the text block, or the attribute variable, and more complex controls, like those that contain other controls in them, as in the case of grids. So, in the web panel listing the tourist attractions, we can see that we've implemented the attractions grid as a freestyle grid. This is so that each line loaded may show its information with more freedom, without the need to have pieces of data next to one another in columns, as it happens with data in the case of standard grids. The loading of the grid remains the same, as well as the determination of its base table. It's all the same. Here, we can see that in the load, we're loading the name of the tourist attraction, because we have a procedure that divides it into two lines. The base table of the grid will be attraction. Here, we see the attraction photo attribute, and here is attraction ID. But we also indicate that the freestyle grid is a flex grid. This allows for the image auto-adjustment effect that will depend on the screen size. We could have also implemented it as a horizontal grid. With three columns per page for medium and large sizes, two columns for small size, and one for extra small. Let's now execute. But, besides the controls included in the GeneXus toolbox in a predetermined way, we can also use other controls in our forms. For example, we'll want to modify our home web panel so that now, instead of showing the sort of cards that we designed with so much manual work on the stencil, and defining the classes that enabled us to show the rounded border and others one by one, it'll use these other ones, which are already predefined in the Semantic UI platform. To that end, what we'll do is define a user control in our KB, which we'll copy from that platform to use in our form. The platform offers us a set of controls along with CSS libraries, which, like our themes, will be specifying the style of those controls. Let's make things a little more clear before we go on. Let's go to the bases. The technology that most websites resort to implies a marked language, such as HTML, a styles language, cascade style sheets, and JavaScript. For quite some time now in the web world, the page content has been separated from its presentation format. This is why we have the file in HTML format, which will be interpreted by the browser to show the data on the page requested by the user. And apart from that, the CSS files, cascade style sheets, which define, by means of rules, the way in which that information must be shown on screen, colors, fonts, alignments, sizes, and so on. It's clearly that same separation that GeneXus establishes between the control and its class. This means that, between the form of the web object and the theme that contains the classes that enable it to be shown in a specific manner. In fact, the theme will become CSS at the time of generating the application. What are CSS frameworks? They're CSS libraries prepared for allowing the simplification and the best possible compliance with standards. Here's a list containing just some of them. Let's see the Semantic UI example. As we already saw, it offers a series of controls along with the CSS libraries that manage the design. For example, we can see that, among the controls that offer views of data, there are the card type controls, and here we have a series of variations. Let's take a look at the first option, a simple card. This control comprises an image, and then text information, an icon, and links. If we click here, it'll show us the HTML code, which, as we can see, is the one defining the information to be shown. This information is structured based on classes. These classes exactly will be defining the card's design. They're defined within the style sheets distributed by Semantic UI. Instead of using the one we created manually before, we want to use this card. To that end, we'll need two things: to create a user control object, on which we'll copy the HTML code provided by Semantic UI, and the library with the CSS that defines the style of the classes, which uses this control, among other things. Semantic UI distributes that library, so we'll have to insert that file in the KB to later be able to tell our new object to use it. So, let's start by creating a file object in our KB. We'll call it Semantic UI. Here we search for it. Previously, we must set its GX library extension so that GeneXus will recognize it as a library and will then have the possibility of offering it. In the trial version, the window that shows all the files entered in the KB in this manner is not available. Let's suppose that it was correctly entered. We already have the library in the KB. Let's now create the user control object. We'll find it under the extensibility category, and we'll call it CardUC. Here, we'll paste the HTML that we copied from Semantic UI. And we'll set it up to take the base style of the library that we've just inserted in the KB. The next thing we have to do is replace the HTML information, which is hard-coded information, that is, it's fixed, and we'll replace it with the variable information. Here, we'll have the image's URL, here a title, and here the information we may want to have, for example, a date, plus a description, and extra content with an icon. In order to convert what's fixed content in the HTML into variable content so that we can load it with whatever we wish every time, we'll have to convert it into property, as if it were, for example, an element of an SDT. We can do that using this syntax known as mustache. If we now go to the Properties tab, we'll see them there. Note that this user icon corresponds to a class of the Semantic UI for icons. Let's replace it with this other one, globe icon, which will better match our reality. As of now, this new control will be part of the toolbox for selection. Let's save, under a different name, this last alternative to the home web panel we created with the last version of the stencil. And now, let's replace each of these stencils with a CardUC control. We drag the control, as we did with the predefined ones. Let's see its properties. This will correspond to the Cruises card. We change its name. And note that these properties are starting to appear, corresponding exactly to the names that we use for the properties of the user control. So, we can specify them here, or through the code. Let's now go to the load event. This is a web panel without base table and without grid. There, we loaded the caption of the text block that was much too extended for defining it statically. We can see that if we write the name of the user control and dot, it'll offer us the same properties. So we'll load them here. We show them already loaded. And now, we simply eliminate the stencil that we don't need anymore. And we generate and execute. Here we can see the user control in action. We'll have to do the same for the other three cards. And now we execute. Question. Instead of substituting the four appearances of the stencil with four user control instances, why don't we open the stencil and inside it replace its content with the user control? Remember that the stencil only enables us to define design and not behavior. We can, of course, create our own user controls without copying them from frameworks. We must provide the HTML with the classes and the base style. There's much more to say about this topic. With the possibility of defining user controls, we extend GeneXus' capacity to implement the design system. And this is the end of this close-up on the design system of our final application and the players that take part in its implementation.